Awd Q50 guys out there. I'm gonna help you make your car rear wheel drive, help you do a little bit more slides, a little bit of a burnout action. Let's head over back to the trunk and I'm gonna show you where the ABS sensor is located and how to disconnect it and what to expect from there. Like a light, yeah. Like a light, yeah. Like a light, yeah. Slept through the flight, yeah. Not for the night, yeah. 767, man, this shit got double bedroom, man. I still got scores to settle, man. I crept down a block. Step one, turn off the car. Let's head over to the trunk for step two. Alright guys, so we're here at the trunk and what I'm about to do is disconnect an ABS sensor which will basically let all the power go to the rear wheels, which will then make it rear wheel drive. Instead of all the four wheels spinning, it's only going to be the rear wheel.
Alright guys,
so what we're going to do, we're going to peel back this mesh piece in the trunk right here and we're going to need something pointy, something like you can use your regular infinity key. As you peel back with one hand, there should be one sensor right here, it's white. You can press down with the key at the very bottom of the sensor, clip opens up, and you just push straight down. There you go, you just unplug that, and your car is rear wheel drive.
Say that again.
Alright, so we're back in the car. We're gonna turn the car on. Now don't get scared when you see a few codes pop up on your dash, okay? It might look like a Christmas tree, but it's totally fine. It's just letting you warn that your ABS sensor is disconnected, warning, malfunction, all-wheel drive error, that's totally fine, okay? A lot of people usually add on the traction off, so you're fully disconnected now, and you can actually do a burnout. We'll be right back.